Hi, Dr. Paul Feuerstein here from Dentistry Today, technology editor. I'm here with Danny from Ivoclar Vivadent. Danny, how are you?
Paul, doing great, thank you.
What do you do for Ivoclar Vivadent?
I'm a senior marketing manager at Ivoclar.
Yeah.
One of the products I manage is the Bluephase line of curing lights.
It's been around for quite a while, hasn't it?
It has.
I think it's been, the Bluephase, to me, has always been an innovative product because you were one of the first companies to take it and do a full spectrum by using some fancy different configurations of LEDs, as I understand it.
Yes, that's correct. We call that polywave technology to provide a broadband spectrum.
So there must be some evolutionary things happening with the blue phase lights. The diodes have changed, the LEDs have changed, I assume, a little bit. So tell me a little bit about the blue phase light and about curing lights in general. I mean, you just take the composite, you just stick it on the composite, it sets it, right?
Well, it's an interesting topic, Dr. Paul, because you know when your colleagues have failures in the practice, and
it's the material.
That's what they typically attribute it to, don't they? Either the material or the technique. We're finding the research is showing that approximately half of resin placed restorations placed will fail within the first 6 years because of improper polymerization of the material.
So the curing wasn't proper in the first place?
Right, so maybe it's not the material or the technique, you know, it could very well be the curing light.
But if the curing light has LEDs, don't they stay stable forever?
Certainly. We get what we pay for, Dr. Paul. Here at Ivoclar, we pay a little bit more premium price for our LEDs because they're pre-sorted to make sure that they're high-quality LEDs that will last for years to come.
And the other thing I can tell you, I know for a fact as a practitioner, sometimes we get stuff stuck on the edges of the lights also.
Which could affect intensity as well.
So there must be a way, I'm leading you on and you know where we're going, but there must be a way to test my light somehow.
Yes, so it's very important that when shopping for lights that we look for lights that are highly rated, like the blue phase light and others. And secondly, it's important that we constantly check our lights to make sure that they're performing as they should be.
So do you have some sort of a meter?
We do. So here at the Chicago Midwinter, we're introducing the latest Bluephase meter. This is the Bluephase meter 2 that has, it's quite unique. It's not like, it's unlike any other radiometer that's on the market.
I see. Well, it looks like the spot where I put my light on looks a little larger than what I'm usually used to seeing.
Right. Most radiometers, the way they measure the light intensity, there's a small little light
spot,
sensor.
Yeah, it's like a little circle.
Exactly. Whereas the Bluephase Meter 2, the whole entire surface area is one large photo sensor.
I see.
So it will capture all the light that's being emitted and provide a much higher accuracy.
But I have different size tips. I have different size curing lights. So like, let's say this is 8 or 9 or 10 millimeters in diameter. Is there some way to calibrate that too with the system?
It does. It could be used to measure any curing light, not just any LEDs. So any curing light that has a probe or no probe or any other type of plasma arc, for example, or what have you, it has the ability, just using buttons on the meter, to adjust for the
diameter of the millimeters of the spot.
Exactly.
I see. And what's a decent reading number? What are we looking for in terms of the intensity of the light coming through the system?
We want a light that operates at least 1,000 milliwatts per centimeter square.
So if I'm running at 750, that's not happening.
We could be having issues potentially.
So does it have to do with depth of cure or cure in general?
When looking at depth of cure, we want to make sure that, A, we have a high intensity, okay, and that's why we use the meter to ensure that we have the intensity.
Right.
And also, we need to ensure that we're using a light that can deliver the light energy in a way that it will get to the bottom of the restoration. And with the blue phase lights, we use these what we call straight probes, that where the light travels in a collimated fashion, so it can get down deep into the
material. It's fiber optic, so it's going to go right around the bend anyway.
Correct. It's going to travel through the glass light guide down into the bottom of the restoration.
I see. Well, this is quite interesting because this is something we take for granted. We just say shoot the light, whether it's a gun or a thing like this, and assume it's going to work. And I guess you can't assume that anymore. So how often should we be checking our lights?
We should be checking our lights constantly, at least once every couple of weeks, at least once a month, and keep a log of what the measurement is and see if there's any kind of trending that's going on.
I like the music that's going on. Well, this is what happens when you're a live show. And anyway, a couple of quick questions before they shut this crazy music off. How do we get more information about this light? Is there a website from Ivoclar Vivadent?
There is. Certainly, they can visit ivoclarvivadent.com.
That's as simple as that.
Simple as that.
Danny, I got to tell you, terrific.
Dr. Paul, my pleasure.
I learned an awful lot. Thanks
so
much.
Thank you so much. And make sure three of the six products...